Everybody have a clicker handy?
Trading books for technology used in a popular game show. The college classrooms transforming into interactive learning zones. The days of chalkboards and textbooks are certainly a thing of the past for some classrooms.
New at 10, WISN 12 News, Hillary Mintz shows us some new devices being used and how it's changing education.
Does everybody have a clicker handy?
First question.
Can you enter into your clicker whether you're a male or a female?
Now it's time for all of these UW-Milwaukee nursing students to answer.
So it looks like we have 21% of males.
You've probably seen this type of audience participation before, but in a college class? Rewind a few years ago and this might have looked more familiar, the lifeline.
So I'm going to ask the audience.
Good for you. Okay, audience, just remember this. We're going for $1 million here. Woo! 40% said yoo-hoo.
Next question. By definition,
UWM Associate Nursing Professor Janet Bitson uses the same technology from Who Wants to Be a Millionaire to get her students involved in class, and the clicker is now campus-wide.
Yeah, I think it really helps to have them participate in the class and stay awake and stay focused.
Bitson says it serves students better to adapt to the ever-changing tech world rather than fight it. Besides iPads, iPhones, and laptops, the clicker also puts knowledge right at their fingertips.
I mean, it is easy to get distracted, but then that'll draw you back in, so I think it's definitely a positive thing.
Marquette also uses the student response system among many forms of newer technology.
Classrooms here and at many institutions will be what are called smart classrooms now.
In fact, BYOD, or bring your own device, is becoming a popular trend.
You bring a laptop, you bring a cell phone, you bring an iPad. You bring some sort of personal device that we as the institution are going to try to get content to.
Graduate student Jessica Rout says her anatomy book is on her Kindle, which weighs and costs less.
Having downloading things is a lot cheaper than buying the actual textbook itself. Still, textbook's about $70 for, you know, a brand new one, and on the Kindle you can get for about $10.
Courses also have websites where material and lectures are posted.
Marquette says new technology expands education from beyond the four walls of the classroom, but with everything so accessible, does it encourage students to stay at home?
One way professors discourage that is by taking attendance and counting participation points, which go toward final grades.
There's sometimes, yeah, obviously you feel like you don't want to go to class all the time, but, you know, the teachers are there to teach you.
Marquette says they're confident despite rapid changes to curriculum from technology upgrades, the traditional feel of college will survive. In Milwaukee, Hillary Mintz, WISN 12 News.
Some Marquette professors still ban cell phones in class to keep students' attention, but it is not a university policy. The name of the student response system is called Turning Point from Turning Technologies.
And now